Welcome to Washington. You're watching Hack 5.
"Balls," said the queen. "If I had them, I'd be king." And that has absolutely nothing to do with today's episode, but it is a quote from my mom, and I kind of love it. The other is, the difference between men and boys are the prices of their toys. And to be honest, you know me, I trust my techno lust. And you know who else does? My good friend, Glitch!
Hello.
Who's here in the Pacific Northwest, and we're just hanging out, and I thought, you know what better place, what better person to ask, what's in the hacker bag?
So I'm using a Vism tactical bag. It's a first responder's bag, and they're really well built. One of my main reasons for using this bag is the front flap flips open, so you have access to everything in your main pouch while it's on your shoulder. You don't have to take it off your shoulder to get access to everything. This is my soldering kit, and I'm using a TS-80 iron. And it's just a USB-C powered iron. There's some tweezers in here, your cable to run it. Normal soldering stuff. I always carry a voltmeter as well, multimeter, clamp. And then the Weeha bit set. I don't normally use all of the bits in this set, but I could probably minimize this, I think. Lime SDR, I don't normally carry this. It's just a nice thing to have. Software-defined radio. And it does, I think it's like 30 megahertz to 3.8 gigahertz. It's good for all kinds of fun stuff, GSM, and so on. So I have tinnitus, and that's basically ringing of the ears. And so I always have multiple ways to listen to music and just fill dead air. And so this is just a little cheap MP3 player. There's some things that could be better about it. The brightness is actually, at night, it's too much. But it works, it plays music. On top of the headphones I always have on me, I have earbuds. These are Bluetooth ones, Soundbud Flows. They're pretty decent. And then I also have these ones, which are basically earplug style. And they're great because they sit far enough inside your ear that you can sleep with them in. I really like them. And this is just the case they came in, so. Spare phone. I always have a spare phone. This is just an Essential PH1.
What's your primary phone?
That is a ZTE Axon M. And I like it because it's a dual display phone. It's like a two-year-old phone. It's $150 refurbished, $200 new. And dual screens, it's replaces a tablet. I don't carry a tablet anymore. So, in the front here, I have my main battery. And this is a bit excessive, but it is an OmniCharge 20. And it's got dual power distribution, 60 watts on either one, 100 watts combined. It's an awesome little power pack. It's not too little. And that's the thing I'd change, is this thing's heavy, it's bulky, it just barely fits in this front pocket. If I were to change something, this is a major one I'd be looking at. Cables, well, need I say more? And then this is a great little power brick. It's just an iHome. Does 45 watts USB-C, or power distribution, and then two 2.1 amp ports. And it'll do all of that at full bore, no problems. It's nice and compact, relatively light. So up here I have the Osmo Pocket, and this is a great little gimbal. I have been very much enjoying using it. And, yep, there you go. It comes with a nice little carrying case, keeps it all protected. And it's just, I really enjoy using it. I keep it on me as well as my RX100, which we're using at the moment.
RX100, Alec.
And on the bottom of that RX100 is a handheld tripod. And I got this for the DJI Pocket, and it just keeps the phone locked in as well as the camera, so you don't have the USB port wiggling, you're not putting any stress on anything. Cold shoe for a mic if I wanted. It's just a great little piece to go with the Pocket. To go along with my camera gear, the Pocket specifically, I've got this lav mic and this lav mic adapter. This is just a Sony stereo mic. It's not too bad. This is $54. It's kind of ridiculous. But yeah, that works well. And then SD cards, because you can never have too much storage. Little SD card reader, it's pretty quick. Batteries for headphones and mice and whatever else. Oh, and to go along with something that I keep in my pocket, this is my Nightcore flashlight. And it's a great little right angle flashlight that I love because it comes with this strap that I always keep in my bag. And this just goes together like this. And suddenly you have a headlamp that is also a flashlight. And so if you're cruise around on some sketchy streets and you need a little more light, this is great. And it's really bright too. I think it's like 1100 lumens. Down here in this little pouch, I just have some cables. And of course, all the Hack 5 goodies.
Domain.com has all of your website needs from .com and .net to intuitive website builders. Create your online identity with their affordable, reliable tools. Even brand yourself with over 300 extensions from .club to .space. Domain.com loves Hack 5, which is why you get 15% off domain names, hosting, and email when you check out with coupon code HACK5. When you think domain names, think domain.com.
On the shoulder here, I have my ham radio. It's just a Baofeng UV5R. nothing too special. On the side, I have my antenna, nice big whip antenna. This is a Nagoya NA320A. It's about the longest antenna that I can fit in this bag without it sticking out somewhere. And that just screws on as you'd expect it to. On the side here, Wi-Fi pineapple, which I mainly keep for the purposes of having the extra battery, but whenever you need a pineapple, you've got a pineapple. And then water bottle, this is just a thermos flask, nothing too special. And the Gonex water bottle carrier on the side here. Alpha card and antenna, and in the back a comb because my hair is ridiculous. And that just leaves this guy. This is my canister drone. This is a little project I've been working on for a while. And as the name implies, it is to be canister fired, or more specifically, out of a 40 millimeter airsoft grenade launcher. And it's designed to be really compact, really easy to use, and eventually there will be six of them. I've been building this on my channel, youtube.com/glitch, for quite a while. And I'm hopefully going to be getting it to a state where it's flying pretty quickly. And it's meant to be equipped with sensors like thermal cameras, daylight cameras, radio repeaters, anything that can aid search and rescue efforts.
Glitch, I have to say, of all of the gear in your kit, and as somebody who has traveled the globe with very much similar kind of gear, that's the one that I'm most excited about. This search and rescue drone is absolutely sick. So if you haven't already checked out Glitch's YouTube channel, you have to go and check this out. I've been watching this project progress, and it's just really heartwarming to see like what's possible when you're making your own PCBs and stuff. That's pretty fantastic. I know you all also published some stuff about this on your Twitter. Where can people follow that?
That is at Glitch Tech.
Awesome. Glitch, thank you for showing me what is in your bag. I know as a person that trusts their Technoless as well, it's very nice to see like what somebody else is packing. Appreciate you coming on the program, man.
Thanks for having me on.